Your boots are unquestionably one of the most important pieces of hiking equipment that you own. And from spring through to autumn, your regular walking boots will probably do you fine. But come winter, you need something a bit different. In this type of weather, you need a proper pair of winter walking boots. And this video will show you what to look for and how to get the perfect pair for your feet. The first thing to note is that winter boots will be much stiffer than usual walking footwear, and you can test the fitness by giving them a flex and a twist, and you'll see with a solid winter boot like this, there really isn't much give. Why is this stiffness important? Well, more so than with any other footwear, winter boots are used as a tool. This stiffness is essential for kicking steps into ice or snow slopes, and also to make them compatible with the most technical mountaineering crampons. Another key feature of winter boots are good aggressive lugs on the outsole. And this is simply to allow the boots to offer maximum traction on snow and ice, but even damp and soggy grass and mud. A good heel breast depth, that drop between the heel and the toe, is also important, particularly to allow braking when going downhill. Winter boots take a hell of a thrashing, so durability is key. You want a boot which has minimal stitching on the upper for maximum robustness, and a rand that runs around the entire front and back and side of the boot for maximum protection. Naturally, waterproofing is also important. So you want a leather boot that can be waterproofed itself, or a boot which has a built-in waterproof membrane, such as Gore-Tex or a proprietary alternative. As with all footwear, getting the right fit is essential. Now, these Scarpa Mantas work brilliantly for me, but they might not fit your feet, so it's important to go into a shop and try them on and get the fit absolutely spot on. It's not unusual sometimes for people to go up half a size with their winter boots, or even a whole size, to allow for wearing thicker, warmer socks. So when you go and try your boots on, make sure you're wearing the socks that you'll be wearing with your winter footwear. Make sure that the laces do up nice and snugly across your feet. And ideally, you want to be able to get one finger width down the back of your boot so that your toes aren't knocking at the front when you're going downhill. Because they can be so much stiffer than regular walking footwear, walking in winter boots can feel a bit cumbersome. So when you're trying them on, walk up and down in the shop and feel for that rolling motion that winter boots often have, which help you walk more comfortably. A flexible ankle cuff can also make this process more comfortable. And again, it's all about trying them on and making sure they're right for you. Of course, one of the most important factors of winter boots is crampon compatibility. Now, while very flexible crampons can be used with regular footwear, for proper winter walking, you want to be able to use more technical crampons, and for that, you need a specific type of boot. Most winter walking boots will have a crampon welt at the back there, which allows the clip-style crampon to be used. But you can also get fully strap-on crampons, which will strap on at the front and the back for use with a wider range of boots. Very technical footwear will have a crampon welt at the front as well. That tends to be more for high-end mountaineering and climbing. Traditionally, boots were given a B rating, from B0 being the most flexible to B3 being the stiffest and most technical. The idea being that you would match that up with a C rating, the crampon rating. Again, C1 being the more flexible crampons, C3 being the stiffer, more technical type. And that kind of rating system has gone out of favour a bit, so the easiest thing to do is go into an expert shop and get the advice when you're buying your boots as to which crampons they recommend for them. With lacing, ideally you want the ability to lace right from the ankle cuff at the top as far down the toe as possible. Being able to lace nice and low down gives you a snug fit across the toe for a more precision feel, very useful for climbing more technical ground. Hopefully that's given you all the key information you need to find your perfect pair of winter boots. Remember, you can find more gear reviews and advice at liveforTheOutdoors.com.